Well, after the National Company Law Tribunal put out the written order that they have passed on the resolution plan by Piramal Capital and Housing Finance Limited for DHFL, the Committee of Creditors of DHFL are all set to meet tomorrow for the first time after the acceptance of the resolution plan. Now, remember when the NCLT passed the oral order as well on 7th of June, and in the written order as well, they have requested the COC to reconsider the distribution of funds for small creditors as well as fixed deposit holders. And they have said this, you know, in line with what happened in the SR case, where the Supreme Court had directed the Committee of Creditors to give equal distribution of, you know, returns to small creditors as well as the larger financial creditors, so that the small creditors don't lose out, and there will be an equal amount in terms of percentage of recovery that will happen for all creditors. Now, what we understand from sources is that the COC will meet tomorrow to consider whether they want to change the distribution of funds amongst small creditors and fixed deposit holders or not. Now, this is something the NCLT has said that they have 2 weeks' time. The COC must consider this within 2 weeks and revert back. So that is the plan, and they're also going to be meeting to discuss other things mentioned by the NCLT in the order, including giving a separate class of creditors to the army group, where NCLT said that they should be given a separate subclass and they should be given a full recovery of 39 crores, that is the admitted claims amount. All of this is going to be discussed in the Committee of Creditors meeting tomorrow. Now, what we are also picking up from sources is that the monitoring committee that the NCLT had asked to be set up, that committee will take over once this entire process of getting back to the NCLT is completed. The COC will get back to the NCLT on the decision on the distribution of funds, after which the monitoring committee will come into place. Now, remember what the NCLT has said is that one, the monitoring committee is going to be set up till the implementation of the resolution plan, so that they can keep a tab on what activities are really going on. The committee will have 3 COC nominated representatives, the RBI administrator, 2 representatives which will be nominated by Piramal, and also they themselves have appointed former SEBI ED Ashok Kakkar on the committee. So these representatives who have to be nominated, we understand the names have been given by the banks and also by Piramal, and this committee will be formed once the entire process with NCLT is done. Remember what NCLT had said is that the implementation of the resolution plan should happen within 90 days from the day of the order, that was June 13th when it had come. Within 90 days, it should be completed, excluding litigation. So that is something that we have to watch out for, because Kapil Wadhwan's plea is pending in the Supreme Court for his payment proposal to be considered as well. And apart from that, 63 Moons is going to go to higher courts to go against the NCLT order on the acceptance of the resolution plan by Piramal. All of these litigations will determine how long it really takes for Piramals to complete the acquisition of DHFL going forward. But as of now, the COC will meet tomorrow and take a call on whether they want to increase the payout for FD holders and small financial creditors and a few other things on the way forward.